everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm talking about items that the internet made me buy and the ones that worked and the ones that didn't. And believe me, there are some that didn't. I'm gonna start off with the infamous rainbow highlighters, okay? Because I couldn't get the highlighter from, was it Bitter Lace something or other? I can't remember the name. But the waiting list, it was from Etsy, and the waiting list was like a year. So I went on eBay and I found three highlighters. And I have another one too. I can't, it's like this big. I can't find it though. But this one is Miss Wi-Fi. Y-I-F-I. It's very, very pretty. So this one I wouldn't really recommend. Oh, you know what? I didn't even know that that was like that. I didn't even know it came with a mirror and a little sponge thing. Is it supposed to be eyeshadow? That'd be kind of different if it was eyeshadow, because it doesn't say. It's just weird. And this one, see again, it doesn't say where it's from. It doesn't even have a name. But this one is more pigmented than that one. But again, it's kind of, you can tell that it's not high quality. And this little guy is Naris. I don't know, it's kind of pretty. And this one looks the most like the one that you can get. It's pretty highly pigmented. You can see that. This is the one I would recommend if I can find it again. It was on eBay. All I did was search for rainbow highlighters, and I found them. Another thing on eBay that I found since the highlighting trend began and everybody's cheeks have to be glowing to the universe. This, one swipe. And it goes on really, really well. I don't have good lighting here, but I think I got this for $3 and something, and it is absolutely worth every penny. It's ODBO Vivid Baked Highlighter. Another thing that the internet made me buy was this big ol' Indian Healing Clay, world's most powerful facial deep pore cleansing. And I have not had a chance to use it yet because incidentally today I was getting the raw apple cider vinegar and I got it today, but it came broken. And well, obviously if you're going to be bringing something to Winnipeg, you're going to have to really pack it well because it's going to freeze. So obviously it froze and broke, so I sent it back, and hopefully I can get a hold of Amazon and get them to send another one out. So I haven't really tried this yet. So if any of you have, I've only watched one video on this, and I think it was by Stephanie Lang, and she swore by it, but I have not seen it anywhere else, although I haven't really searched, to be honest. But if anybody's used this, let me know what you think, because I need to wait until I can get some raw apple cider vinegar. And also, do you need raw apple cider vinegar, or can I just go to the grocery store and get apple cider vinegar? That's another question I have, because I had to specifically order raw apple cider vinegar from Amazon for like $8 and something, where I can go to the grocery store and get apple cider vinegar for like $2. So I'm wondering, is there a difference? Like, does this react differently with it? Let me know in the comments if you have, because I'd like to know. This is from Lush, and it's a shampoo bar. Oh, this one, I can't remember the name of, but it's this color one. Oh my goodness. It smells so good and works fantastic. I had one last me over a month, and I still have like some left where I can use in my hair, but I'm not using it in my curly hair right now. But I have hooded eyes, as you know, so I have to, you know, apply my makeup extra careful, and I have to make my own cut crease higher than my crease, because if I don't, then you won't see the eyeshadow because of my hood. So I thought, well, I'm gonna buy this eyelid glue and these magic strips from Sephora. I got these, and I got this from eBay. And this, what you do is you put the eyelash, like you put the glue on your eyelash or on your eyelid with this, and then you take this little guy and you push the glue in like that and you hold it. Well, all it does is put glue on your eyelid and make it hard to come off, and it does not do nothing. So this bomb, this is just tape, and it shows you what it looks like with and without tape. And you can see that this one, you can see the crease, and this one you can't, and this is like my eye. Well, it's just tape and it does not stick to oily eyelids. So I don't know why they think these things work, but they don't. If any of you have hooded eyelids and have tried it, let me know in the comments, because it hasn't worked for me. And I'm not dissing these products at all. I'm just giving my own opinion on how they worked for me. Now, I got the Urban Decay D-Slick Makeup Setting Spray Oil Control, and I got the e.l.f. Matte Magic Mistin Set. These two are almost identical to me, except the price. This one is expensive. This one, not so much. This is a little version of this. I would swear that they are the exact same ingredient. I would definitely recommend the e.l.f. Nothing against Urban Decay, but I mean, if you can get the same product or the same outcome from a cheaper brand, why wouldn't you? Why would you want to spend more money for the same thing you can get for, you know, a quarter of the cost, right? So, something to keep in mind. Again, if you guys have had an opportunity to try them and you've had the same success, let me know. These whitening things do nothing. I've tried 4 different brands of these, and they're like a little brush that you brush on your teeth to whiten them. They don't work. They don't work at all. And I got this one, actually the exact same one, and I got it from Dollarama for $2.50. The other one I got was online for like $20, and I thought that was cheap. Well, I tried them both. They're both identical. They both feel the same in my teeth, but they don't do anything. And they both taste the same. So I don't think those work worth of poo. Foundations. This little guy I actually found from Stephanie Lang's channel. Again, she has the same skin as me. Oily, dry, sensitive. This stuff is amazing. It is Chanel Perfection Lumiere Velvet Foundation. And I'm in 10 beige, but I also have 20, number 20, which is a bit darker for summertime. This stuff makes my skin look fantastic. This is the best foundation that I have ever used in my entire life. Unfortunately, it's very, very expensive. It's about $70, $75 Canadian for this little guy. So I use it sparingly. I switch between foundations, but I thought, well, this one's CoverGirl Clean Matte. I seen this online, and some people liked it, some people didn't. So what I like to do is I like to try products myself and see if they work for me. Just like you guys, if you guys have tried these or want to try them and they work for you and they didn't work for me, that's great. If they work for you and they work for me, fantastic. But this did not. My face after a couple of hours was that oily feeling, and you can see the creases. Like it did nothing for me. And it even says like for oily skin, and it says matte, clean matte. It does not mattify your skin. Not for me anyway. I got this as a sample to try out before I spend the $90 or whatever it is insane amount to buy this. It's the Dr. Brandt May Magnetite Age Defier Skin Recharging Magnet Mask with the magnet. You know, I tried it and it was okay, right? Like it's like black and you put it on your face. But the thing is that I had, and I didn't see anybody else having the problem, but I found that this magnet wasn't strong enough to get rid of the product from my face. I've seen other people using a different magnet because they were sharing the same thing, but they needed to use a different magnet, I guess from a different type of magnet mask. And it was like round with a little stem so you can hold it, and it took off the product perfect. But this little guy just didn't do it. Like it's not strong enough to get rid of the product. So if it had a better magnet, definitely, but I'll try something else. But it's a good idea. Like I really like how it comes off, but it's just not strong enough. Mr. Charles Gross, thank you. Let me just say, I hope you're feeling really well. He followed me on Twitter yesterday. Whoop, whoop. I love you, you know, you're an awesome person. I love you. I love your channel. He's sick, so he didn't film a video for the first time in, I think, ever. And I hope you're feeling better, and I can't wait to see you on your next video. He made me buy Tom Ford's Black Orchid. This is just a little guy. I didn't want to bring the big one down, but oh, it is amazing. You are right. This is awesome. I hope you marry Tom Ford one day. Another product that I got was the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector Slim Light. I got two of them. I got this one and I got the one in, was it Champagne Pop? I don't find that these are that great. Like I thought it would be good for the inner corner, but they're not that pigmented as some of the other drugstore ones that I bought. Like I thought, oh, this is gonna be perfect, like right in the inner corner to brighten up the eye. It didn't work. This is Wet n Wild. When metallic lipstick, liquid lipsticks first came out, Wet n Wild had to get their hands in the pot, and this is their color icon. Colors are great. Stay. But I don't know. It just didn't stay on my lips. Like, it came off fast. It wasn't, there was no staying power. I just wouldn't recommend it. I mean, it's good for the price. I mean, it's very inexpensive, but... And this is Hourglass, the popular red one that they have. It's the opaque rouge icon. This one gets a lot of positive reviews on YouTube. But... And it's a great color. Like I love the color, but I don't find that it stayed on my lips. Like people said that it stayed on for 8 hours. I was wearing this when I was working, and it did not stay on, like even when I was drinking through a straw. So, bomb. This is the Urban Decay Sparkly Sweet Body Balm in Pina Colada. I've never seen this in stores. I don't know, it's weird. But the smell, oh my goodness. Like it doesn't really do anything. Like, oh, every now and then I'll just take it and put some on my finger and just stick it on the tops of my hands to, because I like to put cream on here because that's where your hands look like they're getting old. Well, because I am old. Lastly, the infamous Skinny Dip from Joy. Oh my goodness. These ones, this is the Skinny Dip one. And I love the smell. It almost smells like caramel. And they are fantastic. This is the Skinny Dip. You can hardly see, but it's a lot better. And then they came out with tan lines. Oh, same wonderful caramel smell. And these make your lipsticks pop. There's the tan lines. And then lastly, they came out with Frostbite. And they make, like, I just put a little bit on here. Like, I'll just go. And it just gives my lips sparkle. And it smells so, so good. So this is the Frostbite one. Let's see if we can get a better view. See, there's all three. They're hard to see. I have the light, I know, but they look a lot better in real life. So those are my dump and not dump. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you've tried any of these products and what you thought of them, if they worked for you, if they didn't. Let me know of any products that you want me to try on here. I will gladly go out and buy them with my own money, and I'll try them and I'll let you know how they work. So whatever you want to know, leave them in the comments. And you guys have a great day. Charles Gross, you get better. We need some videos from you. And my baby bees, I will see you in my next video. Love you guys. Bye.